are in science fiction history, in an age of hydrogen bomb apocalypse, the very Kali Yuga wherein men's stupidity so overwhelms the planet that ecological catastrophe begins to rehearse old tribe tales of karmic retribution. Fire and flood and Armageddon ending. Poor Dr. Leary, poor Earth. It would be natural, in fact deja vu, that the very technology stereotyping our consciousness and desensitizing our perceptions should throw up its own antidote, an antidote synthetic, synchronous with mythic tribal soma and beyond. Given such historic comedy, who could emerge from Harvard technology but the one and only Dr. Leary, a respectable human being, a worldly man faced with the task of a messiah? Inevitable! Poor Dr. Leary, poor Earth. Accelerated evolution. Psychosocial revolution. Alteration of human consciousness. Rapid mutation. Staggering realization. Psychedelic. Consciousness expanding, mind manifesting in itself. Images of our own unconscious rising from the streets of Chicago, where city tear gas was dumped on Christ's very cross in Lincoln Park, AD 1968. The drains are backing up in the cities. Smog, noise, and physiologic poison in food turns us to insect acts. Overpopulation crazes the planet. Our lakes corrupt, old riverways become dank fens, tanks enter Prague and Chicago streets simultaneous. Police state arrives in every major city. Starvation wastes African provinces. Chinese genocide in Tibet mirrors American genocide in Vietnam. Alarm, alarm, howls deep as any biblic prophecy. Despite the scary contumely of fellow academicians, the dispraising timorous irony of scientific professionals, the stupidity, meanness, self-serving cowardice and hollow vanity of bureaucratic personnel from Harvard Yard to Mexico City to Washington, from the ignorant sheriff's office in Dutchess County, New York, to the inner greedy Gordon Liddy haunted sanctums of the U.S. Treasury Department in D.C., our whole establishment of civilization that defends us from knowledge of our own unconscious by means of policemen's gloves and would resist the liberation of our minds and bodies by any brutish means available, including tear gas, napalm, and the hydrogen bomb.